Hello guys and welcome to very unusual video about myself that I share actually my opinion about wargaming. Actually, this is first time I would like to say hats on for wargaming that makes this small present to all of you in this rough stormy seas, dear captains. As you can see here, they literally give away 14 days of premium account, which is nice. I believe, guys, without saying too much, it's not much of a loss for them. Even though they, you know, could do better or they can do the worse, but I believe 14 days of free premium time, it's nice. And you know, I very much would like to say I very much appreciate it, not just for me, but for all my subscribers, all my viewers, everywhere in the world, because it is a very unique situation we do have here. And I've been thinking a lot of thoughts about those country and those states and different places that you're not allowed to take your bicycle, let's say walking through a park or a lake or fishing, you know what I mean, your choices in life's it's limited. And I really feel sorry for all those countries, and one of those countries, our neighbors Finland. In Sweden, we never gonna happen. Our government will never put this restriction that you're not allowed to go from your home. That never gonna happen. It's about this unique, shall I say, I have no quite word, but I believe no matter how bad situation there will be in Sweden, we never have this stupid law that you're not even allowed to take your walk into the wood, or you know, doing your own choice of life in within country. That's what I'm trying to say. Yes, Sweden, as all other country, are a close country. You cannot leave or you cannot come if you're not a Swedish citizen. But what I'm trying to say that we have still a choice to make. If, let's say, I want to go to a park or somewhere in the woods or take some pictures in a lake and so on, I can still do that. Unfortunately, I really feel sorry for you guys who probably this choice, it's not the options. So that I do have this feeling for you guys. But now something very positive, and this actually no YouTuber mentioned, but it's a real good thing. Thank Wargaming, even though it's probably not the best idea, but it is. I'm not gonna talk about rank spring. It's rank sprints, 11 season in 0.9.3, 12 versus 12 at tier 9 and tier 10 ships. I can actually make a video about the best tier 9 ships, but it's very obvious that they are a very strong premium one at tier 9. They I highly recommend. But now the most important, I was looking for so long, Wargaming, it's this improved matchmaking. And I actually can make a link below so you can read it for yourself. But overall, this list and this change is for tier 7 to tier 10 battles. Some strange reason not for tier 6 and tier 5, but probably is because of this limitation. You as a, let's say, tier 6 battleship or any ship, you never can engage and play versus a tier 4 regular matchmaking. So you as a tier 6 ship, you only can face tier 5 as the lowest and the highest tier 8. So they are in the bad spot, in even worse spot in the next patch, when this change of lists are only for tier 7s and tier 10, those ranges. Literally what I'm very much hype and looking forward, guys, is this limitation that you are the only tier 8 ship in a tier 10 matchmaking. This gives you a limitation. Probably the queue will be longer, but I believe, guys, that this is right to go. The truth, I know it's still a game, but it's such a huge gap in tier 8 versus tier 10 that probably some tier 8 ships, let's say overall general, you don't have quite so much HP pool, and you don't have the range, and you don't have the firepower. You cannot trade shots versus a tier 10 ship to tier lower than you. And the same story as actually if you're a tier 7 ship, it's even more murder hard to do any well versus tier 9 ships, because regular tier 7 cruiser, let's say, does not have heal, but tier 8 and tier 9 that they do have heal. So overall, I would like to say that it's more important that you are not getting so many times in this situation that you are the only tier 7 ship versus tier 9s, let's say, which is could be rough, very rough. And also the armor, guys, because, and this is the my final word, the armor's changes has been such a huge thing today that a tier 7 versus tier 8, no matter if it's a cruiser or a battleship, it's improved in armor just between those two tiers. So I would like to say that in some somehow the tier 7 are in worse spot what they used to be for let's say just two patches ago. But I do believe, guys, that even though word game is not going too rough and probably limited this to -2 in matchmaking, they at least assure you that you are not in so many cases that you are, the only ship versus much higher tier. And I believe it's good. It does not matter what kind of ship you're playing, it is a good change. And I very much like to get more information from Wargaming, how much the percentage it's when you're underdog and how many battles, let's say if you play tier 10 battles, all right, and you're, let's say, tier 8 ship, no matter what kind of ship, how many battles do I'm top dog and how many battles I'm underdog. That's how very much I would like to know. And this matchmaking proof does not show you a whole lot, but it's definitely a huge limitation of CV. The CV at low tier, you're never gonna find any 3 versus 3 CV, and also reduce the number how the CV, like 2 CV in and 2 CV in a higher tier, it also be more rare, you know. So that's also good for the game. Let me know in a comment below. So overall, I do believe it's really nice, good looking information, and matchmaking, it's always a huge thing for me, because it is, you know, some strange reason, kind of the one who likes some killing the willing to play, because you are feeling sometimes useless when you're underdog. There are some destroyers who does not quite even care if they are underdog. It's actually a benefit for them, but there are very few ships in this game when it does not matter if you're underdog or not. Most likely it's those stupid overpower ships, most likely are they premium, and they can perform heck even better when they're underdog versus when they're top dog. So thanks guys for watching, and always captains fair seas and goodbye. And don't forget to, when you active this premium account, once you do it, you the clock is ticking, you have exactly 14 days. So good luck with your premium account, guys, and always fair seas and goodbye.